Welcome to Real Civil YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to start a series on structural dynamics. That's why I am covering a very basic part. That is, what is dynamic load and dynamic analysis. Okay, before studying that, I will just take some basic information in front of you. That means, first it's static load. So static load is something that acts constant. Okay, these are the constant loads that does not vary with time. Okay, so these are called as a static loads. All the dead loads are come under static loads. Okay, so this is static load. Now next is dynamic load. Okay, so dynamic load are the loads which intensity or magnitude, direction, point of application varies with time. Okay, so I will first give you few examples so that your concept regarding dynamic load will get clear. So high rise building subjected to wind and earthquake, offshore structure subjected to wave forces, vehicle moving on the road, aeroplane flying. So all these examples of the dynamic load. Here I told you that static load, only dead loads are come under static load. You may think that while analyzing the building, you also consider live load in static. But static load is the live load is actually a dynamic load, but even that we consider under static load. Why is that so? I will explain further. Okay. So as there are static load and dynamic load, so there are analysis also, static analysis and dynamic analysis. I will give one example. Suppose this is a structure subjected to dynamic load. Okay, so our structure will displace. So this displacement is with respect to time. Okay, so that displacement with change in unit time is nothing but velocity. So our structure is subjected to change in velocity. So change in velocity again with time is nothing but acceleration. Okay, so this acceleration multiplied by mass is acceleration multiplied by the mass is nothing but inertia force, and that gets developed when structure is subjected to dynamic load, and this inertia force will act opposite of the external load. So this will act in the opposite direction of the external load. Okay, so being frankly speaking, live load is also a moving load, dynamic load, but it generates very small amount of inertia force, hence we generally neglect it. Okay, so when the mass is small and the acceleration is high, you have to consider when the mass is, so there are, you can consider as a mass is small but acceleration is high. Okay, or mass is high and acceleration is small, in both the cases you have to consider it, the inertia force. When it is significant, you have to consider and you have to do the dynamic analysis. Okay, so this is the background behind it. So let's come back to the dynamic load. So dynamic load, as I told you, that it is time dependent load. So generally there are two types, periodic load and non-periodic load. So name itself indicates, periodic load means it is a repetitive load, same time variation for large number of cycle. Okay, so I will show you figure. Here you can see that it is a repetitive load and same time variation is there and the cycles are more. If this happens for large number of cycle, it will come under periodic load. Okay, example is a rotating machinery is in the building. Okay, this can be the example. Okay, and second is non-periodic load. So time in sentence itself says that if the motion does not repeat itself at regular interval. So there are two cases we can generate. First one is the small duration impulsive load, means load will be high but for small duration. Here you can see load is high but it is for small duration. So that will come under non-periodic load, and second is for long duration. So offshore structure subjected to wave, that means this is acting for long time, but the intensity is not much varying. Okay, so that come under long duration. So examples of non-periodic loads are bomb blast in the building, wave loading on the structure, earthquake forces on the building, vehicle load on the bridge. So all these comes under dynamic load. In under dynamic load, they come under non-periodic loads. Okay, so thanks for watching the video. In the next video, I will inform you about single degree of freedom system and multiple degree of freedom system, and why a single story building is called as a single degree of freedom system. Why not 2 degree of freedom? Okay, that we will explain in the next lecture. Okay, so thanks for watching the video. Please like, share, subscribe the Real Civil YouTube channel.